Good morning. Hope everybody is doing good. Did you prepare our notes? Everything you write in a systematic order? Whatever I teach you, keep in particular order. Otherwise, you cannot follow in future. I get so many comments and so many opinions that you enjoy and study well. You feel any types of doubts, you ask me. See, when there is a doubt, we can easily understand that you follow class in a correct way. If you have no doubts at all, means almost 50 to 55 students are there. After the class, you only a few number chat with me. So many people do not chat or do not ask doubts, queries. This is very bad. Even out of our college, many students ask doubts. But you people do not show interest. Isn't it? This is very bad. We teach you as if that you do not know anything. We are teaching you from the beginning. So, at least you have to keep in mind that we take much strain for you and you are not taking much strain. Normally, some students ask me what is the benefit of studying English language and BA literature. See, ample opportunities are there. Wherever you do not want English, everywhere we want English. And immediately after BA English Language and Literature, you can go for many courses. Even what course and what window is not open for you? All the windows, all the doors are open. Even in the administrative system, you can prepare for IAS. Even YouTube channel has started a particular IAS training program. I shared that link to some people. See, what does it mean that you try yourself? Just like LIC advertisement nowadays is coming, right? You are there only for you. You have to keep yourself. Nobody else will support you and hand on your leg that you step by step go somewhere. No. You should make yourself successful in life. And BA literature, BA English, and whatever course you do, that is only a stepping stone. Many horizons are there to acquire. And do not be frustrated. Some people are frustrated. Why? Sitting home, 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 what is to do? Plenty things are there that you go through. E-books and some books are there that you buy or that you take from the library and read. What can't you do? Lot of things you can do. Recently, I come across a girl, you know. She lost her husband and was very poor. Old age parents were there. And she found much difficulty to pay fee for child in the school. And normally he approached the manager of the school. Manager promised her a sweeper job in the school. Right? It was given in the newspaper. And she, not at all in a hesitation, she took that job and continued almost 2-3 phases. 12 to 13 years as a sweeper, you know, sweeper, cleaning a lady of the school. And she did not stop her passion. Though husband lost, age-old parents are there. Meanwhile, she studied graduation You are sitting in the house with the parents' money you are studying. Since no other opportunities along with this sweeper and cleaner job in the school where her own child is studying, she did her BA and she took her MA and later she got a state eligibility test cleared. Her name is Jinsi in Pathanamthitta district in Kerala. Now what is to say more, she now works as a higher secondary school teacher in the same school. Look what fate she has. What does it show? It shows that all doors and windows are open like this Jinsi. You can be another Jinsi in the future with all the support given by the teachers and the parents and the society. But you people are not doing hard work. You do hard work. So what a that social status she got. 12 to 13 years cleaner girl, cleaner lady, or what is called a sweeper as a worker in the school where her own child is studying. Now she is the higher secondary school teacher with almost 75 to 80,000 rupees salary. That shows the determination. So never be frustrated that you are alone in the house and you have nothing to do. That step by step you acquire this. You have to study 5 subjects, right? You give 1 hour each every day. 5 hours, okay. Then concentrate your studies and get good marks. Along with our materials, the method that we teach here, follow. That you keep. You will be successful. Along with all the expertise given by the teachers here, you keep it in a systematic order. Then you study. Then what all the levels we stopped in the last class? We are slowly entering to the syllabus and one or two areas over. Now we are reaching the different types of sentences, statements over. Am I right? That statement can be converted to negatives, okay? Then we found another type of question forms. How many types of question? How many types of question forms available? Did you ever check in the notebook? Different types of question forms. Maybe we are ready to write a very big essay on that. What is called questions? First one, we can change a statement to an inversion type. And if mox and ox not available, we apply do as an ox and make inversion. Then that type is called insertion followed by inversion. Immediately after the we apply wh word from the back, you will get interrogative. Then after that, you jump into question tags. Then again we jump into choice and choice questions. Then last we enter to indirect module, indirect types. All these in the previous classes we taught you. I hope that you have written in the proper order. After that question form, we have to change into imperatives as a topic. Another type, what is called imperatives. Imperatives are referred, we have to dimensions. One is polite imperatives, then order imperatives. All right, order imperatives and polite imperatives. They will ask you short answer questions like what is imperative or give an example to imperative. According to modern grammar or suprasentential grammar, this can be converted from the base sentence. We get a base sentence that is called statement. We can slowly change into all the steps. That is the success of suprasentential grammar or TG grammar. Later, imperatives, two types. Example, we put, all right, write down. The teacher tells you, write down, stand up. What is the meaning of stand up? You just write, you stand up. Once you write in this way, it will come into statement. But you just rub this subject from the sentence, you will get a order sentence. Stand up. Means what? From the statement, suppose you delete subject, result will be order. Result will be imperatives. You take any statement of assertive or affirmative or declarative type and delete the subject, automatically predicate part will be, if you talk in a very stressful way, you will get order. You get out. I say, last class we told, you get out. You delete, you get out. Enough. That will be order. On the other hand, you add one please as a word in front of this order, you will get imperative politeness. Imperative polite words, polite sentences, request, please write down, please get out, please come here. So what does it mean? You get a declarative, you get an assertive, the change into imperatives by two methods. One method, add please from the back, or delete subject, you will get order. This is the method. Just like you write a request, example, please allow me to do. What is the meaning? Please allow me to do. Allow me to do. Maybe in a command, maybe in an order, but you add please, it will be polite method. Then automatically we'll show you how these all the steps can be converted from the beginning. That I will show you one another example. Say, fifth step is called exclamatory. What is meant by exclamatory? Already studied high school, higher secondary, everywhere. What is meant by exclamatory? It is showing exclamation. We show exclamation, surprise, for what we naturally, how hot it is. Look, look here, how hot it is. We'll put one exclamatory mark. How? It shows our surprise. But, you know, Michael Swann, grammarians, modern grammarians say, or this Michael Swann says, this method, how hot it is showing surprise, and the only method that you can do, you can easily change into a statement. This statement, how? You start a sentence with it, then it will be a statement, simple statement. It is very hot. Sentence over. So all the exclamatory sentences can be converted to a statement by adding as a subject it. Then it naturally coming, it is very hot. What a lovely scene. Another example you take, what a lovely scene. You write like this. What a lovely scene. All right. This is an exclamatory mark. What a lovely scene. Michael Swann says, this exclamatory can be converted to a statement by adding a subject it. Then it is a very lovely scene. Answer will be finished. Or otherwise, it is very lovely scene. It is a very lovely scene. That statement could have been given as an exclamatory in this way. Vice versa possible. Are you okay? So what I try to teach you from a statement, how many possible conversions are there? Or how can you convert them to different types of sentences? We supply a statement, or we supply an exclamatory. How can you change into, suppose we get a statement, how can you change into negative? How negative can to change into question? How question to imperative? How this imperative to be changed into an exclamatory? Five type of modules finish. Could you please tell me which all the steps that we study now? Different types of sentence. First one is statement. And this statement, how we can change into negative. Second step is negative. After this negative, how you think to convert them into a question? And for this question, we have studied different types of questions, which are possible that you apply. Am I right? Follow me. Understand me. So after that questions, you think how can you change into imperatives? Which imperatives? Polite imperatives, order imperatives. And after that you change, how can you put into an exclamatory? For that we can take one example. Balance that you practice yourself. I tell you how. One example. How can you change into five steps? First step. I write a poem. One example. Okay. I write a poem. You get a subject, write a verb, a poem object. First step, statement over. Am I right? Statement over. This is the step by which you have to keep in mind. Then only once they ask you how many write a paragraph on step, different types of sentences, then the fundamental steps are this. This is not available in your higher secondary level or traditional grammar. This is the modern method. My question, how can you convert them to second step? What is second step? To negative. Second step, negative. Here, no marks and primary ox appearing. Then we apply do. Automatically, method, I do not write a poem. Here, do not write a poem, negative. Automatically, you will get a second step, negative. Am I right? This is the method we taught you in the previous week. So, first you get a statement. Then think how to make it to negative. Okay, after putting negative, then third step, how can you change it to a question? For question, different steps are there. Which step is suitable for you that you apply? Whether you want inversion, whether you want insertion followed by inversion, whether you want question tags, whether you can apply choice, whether you apply indirect, whichever possible method you make, that is left to you, that you decide. How can we change possible method, simple method? You apply positive or negative, put inversion. Third step will be, do I write a poem? Third step over. Or any step that you apply in over you. Suppose you apply WHOA to what did I do? I write a poem. What do? I write a poem. That apply. Any type of face by face question that you apply, you will get a third step. Here I applied inversion method. So I got, do I write a poem? Yes, I do. Automatically you write fourth step. Imperative. What I told you to find imperative, just rub this area. This rub area, then remaining will be write a poem. For imperative step will be over. Imperative step will be over. You delete the subject. So once you get a statement, step, you change. You will be satisfied. So write a poem. I told you to write a poem. Write a poem means with more emphasis order. X or Y applying. Arya applying. Please write a poem. Imperative, polite. You apply, please. Please allow me to write a poem. Imperatives, that depends on you, that you decide which approach that you apply there. Automatically, statement changed into negative. Negative changed into question. Then question changed into imperative. Then you write fifth step. What fifth step? I write a poem. Imperatives. What a surprise. You add in a surprise manner. How? Why? What? What a surprise you write a poem. Apply a word of exaggeration. What a surprise. You write a poem like, it is not actually a question, it is exclamatory mark. You apply, you show some words like, just like what, who, hurrah, like what is called, somebody dies, somebody passes away, we say alas. You apply certain exclamatory words from the back, automatically you will get a fifth step. Exclamatory means what? In totality, you reach to the fifth step from the base. We take assertive, declarative sentence, I write a poem, change it into negative, change it into question, change it into imperative, then change it into exclamatory. These are the five steps, fundamental steps. Can you just tell me which all the steps that we follow? First one is declarative statements, change into negatives, then change into questions, any type of questions, whichever that we studied, then change into imperatives, then change into exclamatory. This is the first step that you study different types of sentences. So we slowly, after that, we enter to kernel patterns that you have not studied in your higher secondary level. This is graduation level that you study. What is kernel pattern of sentences? Same thing, but in supra sentential, we in TG grammar, we apply, these are the steps. How? At least you study, we have 7 patterns. First pattern is given there. One is that we started in the last class. First one is S plus V plus O. First step. You study that. We had given you 6 starting number. First pattern, S plus V plus O. Example, all right, John, all right, 8 A. Parota, one example, beautiful example. You like parota? Parota, beef. You like? Very good. So we have first pattern, remember. S plus V plus O. One subject should be there. Subject, 8 parota, 8 verb, parota, object. Step number 1 over. Keep this structure in the mind. First step, how after fundamental steps given here, then go to the kernel patterns, which one is S plus V plus O, where all the sentences will have subject and verb and object that we studied. Underline this and identify whether these elements are coming. Second one, S plus, look here, S plus V plus C. What is this C? What is this C that you had to study earlier? Can I rub this area? Okay. What is C? Instead of this O is always a noun. Here N, parota is a noun. But instead of object here appearing C. What is C? C is complement. You write complement. What is meant by complement? That you have to study in unit number 1. Complement means not a noun, but it is complementary. This area belongs to modifiers. What is a modifier? Did you complete parts of speech in unit number 1? What is meant by modifier? modifier is adjective. Then what is adjective? What is called adjective? We call in modern English ADJ. What is called ADJ? ADJ means one word which qualifies a noun. Example, you tell good, boy. This good is complimenting boy, qualifying boy. So boy is N. This is a qualifier. This word qualifies me. What type of, what kind of boy is he? He's a good boy. Should have studied in parts of speech coming in the unit number 1. That you study. So compliment. So I am trying to tell you what is S plus V plus C. Instead of O, C coming here. So for that you refer to ADJ as a chapter in traditional grammar. What is C? Again I explain what is C. Alright, here, look here. Look here, adjective has a function. One example I will tell you. I'll tell you this C has SC complement and OC complement. Have you anybody heard about this SC complement and OC complement? No. A complicated area, understand. SC means subject complement. You write down somewhere. It is called subject complement. OC means object complement. How complementary function coming? I'll show you. An example. One example. All right. John made me happy. One example. John is happy. Another example. I take this John because John is very popular everywhere. Like Mary. Like Rama and Sita. John is popular. So John made me happy by providing biryani. You like parotta, but I don't like parotta. I like biryani. So John gave me biryani. You like parotta, you go behind parotta and beef. I like biryani. So John gave me biryani. John made me happy. That is why I became happy. So here John subject, made verb, me object. Here John subject, is verb, happy, considered to be object. But in the second sentence, who is real happy? John is happy. Am I right? John is happy here. But in the first sentence, me is happy here. No. So this happiness stands for me. Here this happiness stands for subject. In terms of grammar, in terms of structure, in terms of canal patterns, first sentence is OC, means me is object, that object is complemented by happy. Otherwise, simply telling in a simple way, object is qualified. Am I right? But here, subject is qualified. This is why subject complement. This is object complement. Hope is it clear to you? Very complicated area that you have to study in earlier in higher secondary classes, high school classes, or at least in traditional grammar book. What is OC? What is SC? That is subject complement. How can you identify subject complement is our question. It is this way. The word happy here complementing object. That is called object complement. The second sentence, happy is a word which is not a noun. It is an ADJ which complements the subject John is equal to subject complement. Are you okay? So this method, we can say second pattern, all right, second pattern complement. So here you can write John is happy. Here John subject is verb SC. Verb is happy SC. Automatically going. You can make it John made me happy. Object complement. Basically, sentence pattern is called S plus V plus C. How many over now kernel patterns? Two. Which one? First one, S plus V plus O. Am I right? Second one, S plus V plus C. Then third one. Look here, third one. S plus V plus O plus A. All these you have to study, which will make you confusive later. What is called? what is called A? A is in modern grammar called adjunct. Adjunct. Adjunct is really a technical word, stands for adverb. Modern grammarians won't call adverb adv. We call adjunct. What is adjunct? Or adjunct. First one, S plus V plus O. Second one, S plus V plus C. Third one, S plus V plus O plus A. What is A? Adverbial. How adverbial coming? Look here. Sam, one example. Sam kept the plate on the table. Look here. Look here. Sam, subject, kept verb, the plate, object, on the table. Where did he keep? Where did he keep? On the table. That on the table is A, adjunct. Adjunct. So, adjunct coming. Again, I repeat. Adjunct stands for a group of words which normally stands for adverbial phrases. Here, on the table is adverbial phrase, which is in modern grammar called adjunct. And this adjunct appearing here, pattern will be S plus V plus O plus A. That is called third pattern. For or adjunct. Then fourth pattern. Fourth pattern simply S plus V plus ADV. Symbol ADV. This is group of words coming. Here 1, 2, 3. Adjunct coming, adverbial phrase. Fourth pattern, symbol adverb coming. Symbol adverb. Example, what is adverb that you studied? I again tell you, you have to follow me after learning all the parts of speeches. That belongs to unit number 1. Again, two area up to pronominal system I taught you. That you covered. Again, you go to any traditional grammar book, then study up to conjunction or interjection or article, then you will come this area very easy. Unless you study that area, this area will be difficult. So you have to make a thorough study on all the word forms, like adjectives, like verb, like adverb. Here, fourth pattern is called adverb. Some grammar books is given third one. No worry, 7 patterns should be there. So here 1, 2, 3, 4 over. Adverb, simply put adverb. What is adverb? You have adverb of time, adverb of manner, adverb of place. These are the 3 important one that you have to keep in mind. So once you apply adverb technically, directly on the object position, pattern will be S plus V plus S plus V plus A. Example, here Nitya, all right, is in the hall. Nitya, subject, is in the hall. You write object, which is called A. Where she is there? Where she is now? Nitya is in the hall. It is adverb. So fifth one. So you keep in mind all the sentences can be manner. Here place in the hall, manner. Nitya danced well. That well is adverb. Automatically how she danced, you will get a manner. Nitya danced at noon. You will get a noon, adverb, time. So this is order of adverb when appearing. So first one, kernel pattern S plus V plus O. second one s plus v plus c, third one s plus v plus o plus a, then s plus v plus adv, then fifth one, what is fifth one? S plus v plus o plus c. Here before c coming, without o. Here after o c coming. Example that is called OC. That we studied complementary function has SC function, OC function. SC function here over. This is SC function, complementing subject. Here this complement will do, or will be complement. That is called OC function earlier pointed out. What is called? I made him, a leader, or the class teacher made him a leader. Here this is object, leader quality of him, then automatically it is called OC. Another one is I made him wrong. Another example, him object wrong OC. This is called OC, S plus V plus OC. Am I right? So five steps over. Can I rub these first two? All right, we rub these first two. Okay, then remember first two, which are the first two? All right, then OC. Then we have S plus V plus O. S plus, then we have next one, dative case type, sixth one. S plus V plus O plus O. Two objects coming. We taught you direct and indirect object. In the case study, we studied direct accusative case and dative case. Dative case is indirect object. So this pattern. Example, John gave me a pen. Example, here John subject, gave verb, me object, another object coming, two object. Which one is important? Pen is important, so we call direct. Less important, indirect. This called two objects appearing. One will be direct, one will be indirect. Direct will be called accusative case. Then less important one will be indirect object. This indirect object is called dative case. The vice versa can also be changed into this. Is suppose you consider this is here this is dative, this is accusative. Can be converted accusative to dative, but you have to add two. Example, John gave me a pen. Can be converted, John gave a pen to me. Possible. So once you fix direct and indirect, then you can convert them into how this happening. Last, so sixth one is over. Last one is seven, kernel pattern. Now we are discussing kernel patterns. These are simple one, seven one, that is called S plus V only. This V will be INTRV. What is called INTRV? INTRV is called intransitive verb. That also you have to study intransitives. What is called intransitives? Intransitives, no verb required. In some grammar books, it is written complete predication. Complete predication. There are two concepts are there. Verb of incomplete predication, verb of complete predication. Complete predication means intransitive verb used, no object required. You need not write object. Birds fly. Suppose we write birds fly. Birds fly. Fly itself is over. No need object. So that such verbs are called intransitive verbs. Modern grammar we call INTRV. TRV is there but requires an object. Example here, gave me what? A pen. John gave me what? That gave is a transitive verb. He killed a snake. He killed. Not complete. So such verbs we call verb of incomplete predication. So transitive verbs should have object. But intransitive verb, INTRV, need not have an object. So these ideas that you have to keep in mind. Such words like so patterns S plus V plus, how this pattern coming without object. Now I'll give you one example more. Ramesh died yesterday. Example given by Leach. Ramesh died yesterday. All right, yesterday at Patna. Look here, Ramesh, which pattern this sentence is coming to? Subject, died verb. Yesterday, time reference, adverb. At Patna, again adverb. Such words coming together showing place and time called adjuncts. All right, so you write adjuncts. Ramesh died cannot be removed from the sentence. Ramesh died. This is important area. This area of the sentence is called nucleus. But this area can be removed. Such removable area can be considered adjuncts. All these are adverb. If you want, you put. Otherwise, you. I saw him in the theater. I saw him is important. Whether in the theater, in the college, or somewhere else is coming later part. So, what did I do today? I taught you fundamental patterns. Again, I repeat, statements are there. Those statements can be converted to negatives. And these negatives can be converted to questions. And these questions can be converted to imperatives. Imperatives can be converted to exclamatory. After these fundamental steps, we go to modern grammar method. We have 7 steps. First step is S plus V plus O. Second step like that. It goes, you have to study by heart all the steps and make sentences. So, after this area, we slowly go to our topic is very lengthy one. So, you have to make. I'll give you one more, some sentences. You copy down. If you want, then change into your conversions. How can you convert these sentences? Then things will be over so that you can study well. Right, example. One example. Otherwise, I will write here. Okay. I'll write here. First step. All right, you have to convert it to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fundamental steps. All right, fundamental steps. One example I'll write. All right, killed a snake. One example, simple example. Convert, this is a first step example, fundamental step. Change into negative, then change into question, then change into imperative, then change into exclamatory. Any doubt that you can send me. Then you write 7 steps for kernel patterns. You write first one S plus V plus O, like 7 pattern. You write one example each. All right, then copy down all these in the notebook and show me, then things will be okay. Are you okay? Your examination at hand. This week you will get exam. You write well. I wish all the best. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.